when most of the world was still in chaos, 2 days after what we call the 9/11 incident, a small virus was born. Good evening, distinguished Toastmasters, guests, parents, and my fellow youth leaders. Can you tell me how small a virus is? No one knows, really? How many of you are in seventh year, at least? You haven't studied anything about viruses? So how small is it? It's very small, and it's not visible unless you use a microscope. But you know that it's one of the most dangerous organisms for a human being present on this planet. So just like a virus putting the human body into chaos, I put my family into chaos on the 13th of September 2001. I was born a month earlier than I was supposed to in a small hospital in Pune. Upon seeing me, my family thought I was the angel of the house. Little did they know that I was actually the devil. Of course, they soon realized there was a destructive element. I vandalized anything and everything that came into my hands, be it the walls of the house, my mother's kitchen, or my sister's notebooks. And how would you know that? Once you entered the house, you could see about 2 feet from the wall, crayon scratching. Useless, utter nonsense all over the walls. My sister's notebooks had lollipops on them. Even my father wasn't spared from my antics. The first mobile in the house was broken by my very own hands. How would you know that? Even a rough and tough Nokia phone can't withstand a fall from the second floor. 3 years later, we moved to Chennai, where I started my horrible experience of schooling. During my 9 years of schooling, I have noticed that there are two types of students. The honest type and the devil in disguise type. The honest type show their true nature to the teachers. And the devil in disguise type are the ideal students in front of the teachers. I was a part of the latter. Just like that, 4 years passed by and then we moved to Hyderabad. In Hyderabad, we learned how to play the Casio, how to skate, and also how to deal with unwanted pets. But that's a story for another time. For about 11 months, we lived in Hyderabad, and then we moved back to Pune, where my father acquired a job in the small part of the world map called Jubail. The moment I came here, two words struck my mind. One of them was culture. Any guesses for the second? No. The word was culture and shock. I literally couldn't keep up with the Wi-Fi or the internet over here. The first time I came here, I was literally amazed at how there were no two-wheelers, no honking, no kachra on the street. Since there was no entertainment for a girl in this country, my sister told me that I should start reading books. So I started reading books and I stopped paying attention in class. I read a few series called Percy Jackson and Harry Potter, quite famous, not quite famous to some people. And then I started watching Japanese animations called anime and started listening to a weird part of the YouTube called K-pop, Korean pop music. Since I had nothing else to do, I started sitting in one place and pulling a pencil across a sheet of paper, which was literally nonsense again. But then it became a bit more sense. I started drawing things like book covers. That one is the first book of the series called, I forgot. And this is the second book of the same series. These are two of the protagonists of the anime I'm watching. The current anime I'm watching is called Attack on Titan. And it, in Japanese, it's translated as Shingeki no Kyojin. These are a few of my favorite K-pop artists. Since I have expressed my interest in various cultures and I don't know how to conclude the speech, I'll say goodbye in as many languages as I can. Goodbye. Phir milenge in Hindi. Migham sandipom in Tamil. Ja matane in Japanese. Annyeong in Korean. And adieu in Italian. Thank you.